Alright, and we're back for Let's Play City Skylines Part 2. Sorry, I got a bit of a cold, but let's go ahead and get this going here. So we got a couple abandoned buildings, so we'll go ahead and bolt those them over. Get rid of, let's dezone this. That's probably going to be a problem. Looks like we need a little bit of growth in everything. Residential, business, and industry. We'll get the population up just a bit here. Before we expand the other two, that way we have the workers to fill the jobs. Graveyard. They gotta put, have somewhere anyways to put the dead, I guess. We'll put it as close as we can here. Gonna mess our roads up a bit. Go ahead and extend this out. We'll add a little business, but I do need to change the road, because I want to go ahead and upgrade this to highway since we now have access to it, so we'll put the new roads in first, we'll pause it. This residential, change the paint tool again, really easier. Park it somewhere else. There, we'll be happy. Rebuild. Clinic. Right there. Close enough to the business. Extend this intersection all the way, I guess. Which it was, but sort of messed that up. And add some highways. You can just upgrade a road by hitting the upgrade road. It's a little exclamation point. And you can upgrade your roads. Or downgrade them in certain instances. transport out of the city. We can change this back to business because it can face these rooms. Leave that empty on the residential side. Get all this room for growth over here. I'll go ahead and extend that down as well. Let's start it since traffic should flow. All we're doing is just adding on and not demolishing anything. Need power. They have power. Add a little bit of industry. We got real good growth for houses, so more citizens will come in. The jobs will be available for them. Got that little spot there. Make sure we got water running properly. We'll go ahead and make another line across our grid here. Probably end up doing some sort of dam later on in the game. Going up. Citizens are going up as well. Land value is going up. Forestry industry looks like it's doing pretty good. Check out our landfill. It's only 37% capacity. Longer, we will want to add one, probably within the next 1,000 residents, I would say, at least. Starting to get a little traffic jam there. Seems to be still flowing. That 1,000 residents will start deciding what we're doing for a bus line anyways. And these guys need somewhere to take out the trash. It's hard to do that because we gotta extend it away. So we'll pause it real quick. Probably put it right in here because we're going to stop residential zoning here soon this way so we can turn this into agricultural. Still need industry. Probably expand our residential area just a little bit more this way. Make some new farm area. Make dedicate that industry area to farming. So let's fix that. And now it's gonna be just straight agricultural. In here. We forgot to upgrade that one. We'll do that right now. Busy town. Oil industry specialization. Got a couple new policies. We'll utilize that a little later. But I think we can start doing our bus transit lines. We'll put in a bus depot. Business area. Forestry industry. Connected to the residents. buses out. They'll be going all over, transporting the citizens out west. Normal traffic as far as cars. Perhaps we can connect a portion here for now. See if that helps. Seems to be flowing all right, but we got a jam up here. Let's see. Make this a directional road. But seems to work out fine. You can also put a little business here. A couple of corner shops. The residents don't have to drive as far to get their food. Citizens. Now I think at this time we'll go ahead and don't need to, we still have plenty of room, but we'll go ahead and buy this grid here or here. I'm not quite sure. We'll probably go with this grid here. It's probably the best solution for now. Start building on the other side of the highway. Get that oil industry going. So to buy it, just go to the little globe over here. And you just click on the highlighted square. If you have the funds, you buy it. There's the option to buy it both here. Let's see. There. And then it does tell you what resources are available in that area. So we bought some additional land to expand our city. We really just want to expand our residential area for now. Too close to the highway. Water shortage, so looks like could be a result of power shortage. Yes, we need more power. Bow up. There we go. Now we got all the power. Probably get rid of these windmills too. They're just costing us money. They're not really doing anything for us. Water. We do need to add a pumping station. Put the line. Looks like it's already connected to it. Sewage station. Already spitting out the sewage. Go there. without them being parched. Ooh, got a bit of a fire. Fire department already got it out. Well, it was right next door. Convenient. Lucky fella. The Dell residence. Seem to be having any issues over here. And we're good over here. Got a little bit of business over here. Approaching on 5,000 citizens. Probably gotta expand the Cypress Park here a little bit, I think. Still got a bit of a traffic issue over here. No, we can do about that. I suppose I could make an on-ramp. See if that... Oops. cemetery so they can bury their loved ones and visit them. City's coming out pretty nice. It's wanting us to grow our business.
User joined your channel.
What's up?
Disconnected.
Sorry about that. Almost at the end of our recording here anyways. Got a population of over 5,000, almost 6. Everything's going well. As exciting, we've only added our bus line. Well, actually I think we can end it with a little high note here. It's at a monument. Put in maybe a shopping mall for these guys, you think they'll like that? We'll put it up here. So that ends part 2 of City Skylines Let's Play. I'll try to make it a little more interesting next time for you. I hope you enjoyed.